like to learn how to speedrun Stalker Call for a bit. And I know that like SSonin and Ravex, who are the two like bigger people in running, I think there are a few people who find glitches, but they're the main ones. Have some videos on certain glitches, but they don't really have any like tutorials, like they just have examples. And it's kind of hard to learn how to do certain glitches just from those examples, so I figured
Hey, bro.
I might as well just make a compilation of like little trick tutorials. So I'm just gonna play this and commentate as I do it, and hopefully I give enough tips throughout it so you guys learn all of the tricks. If any of you wanted to start doing this yourself, I would recommend it. It's really fun. And the first trick that we're going to start off with right here is like I'll be doing them in the order that you would do them in the run. I'll just kind of do the route and explain them as I go. The first trick is a trick called the door skip, which is where you're going to try and skip through this door without the key card that is required for it, the key card that you get from Carden. So to do this trick, basically you need to stand against this door. And you need to drop your armor, and your armor needs to fall in a way that it pushes you towards the door and then continues through the door with you. Alright, because whenever two objects are pushing together and you're in between them, the objects kind of gain priority over you, so the armor should just push you through the door. But this is probably the worst trick in the entire game, really, just for how much luck this trick requires. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to save here, and then I'm just going to splice in a segment, and then I'll continue on, like a segment where I get it, and I'll continue on after that because none of the other ones are as hard as this trick is. So I'm just going to do that real quick, and then I'll continue on. So hopefully I remember to splice in the footage of me actually getting the trick, and I'll just kind of explain the setup here for it. If you look in the middle of the screen right now, you should be able to see a little dot as like that's my crosshair, right? The basic setup for this that I use, this seems to be the most consistent way to do it. Take your as you're walking back into the store, take your crosshair and just line it up somewhere around in here. I usually go for like one of these empty spaces in the tile, and then open up your inventory, right click on your suit and drop it, and then you pretty much just need to get lucky and you'll go through if you're lucky. You won't if you're not. One thing that you do need to remember is that you do need to get your armor through. If you can't grab your armor from the other side, you won't be able to get back, which you'll get to see me do in the next trick after this. So, we'll continue on now. Now, this next trick kind of screwed me up for a really long time. I thought it was a really hard trick, mainly because I s was saying it up wrong. But before I show it off, just show off something down here. For any of you that have played this, you'll know that normally whenever you come down here, there's a couple of zombies in there, one zombie back here, I believe. There's a zombie right here, and then once you actually come down here, there's a pseudo giant over there. But none of them are down here. I think their spawning is linked to the card being used. But it also could just be an activator somewhere out there. I don't really know. Now, this door, you aren't supposed to be able to open it from this side. You're supposed to go all the way down there, jump around this big vent, and then come through. And this is supposed to be just a quick, like this is your exit out. But there's this trick where if you look at this door, there's like this one little spot here. This is the door bumping glitch, I guess. with guns. Basically, what you want to do is you want to get a good setup where you're aiming into this spot while leaning, kinda. And then you just want to throw your gun. And it's fairly random getting this trick to work, but it's not as bad as the door, as the other door glitch, I think. Although sometimes it can be a real hassle. Maybe I'll just splice in another thing of me getting it. Once you get it, like it's really easy. But yeah. There we go. All right, so yeah. I don't know. Sometimes leaning helps, sometimes leaning doesn't. But that's pretty much what happens. The door gets knocked that way and just keeps going that way. And an upside to this is if the door doesn't go far enough away, like sometimes the door will only go a little bit away. It might only like go right here and then stop just slightly away. But with the way that doors work in Stalker, if a locked or in this case only openable from one side door is just moved, it suddenly becomes like unlocked. Like this door, if you open it from this side regularly and then it closes, you're allowed to open it from this side afterwards. If you move the door using this glitch, you can open it from either side afterwards. So yeah, that's the basic premise of that glitch, and it lets you just come down in here and grab this without doing any of the other stuff in the rest of the facility. I'll just let this cutscene play.
The documents refer to a central laboratory designated X8, which could contain information about secret experiments conducted in the zone. Our analysts have been interested in this issue for quite some time.
And if you can only knock the door a little bit away, and then it close, like you can run through it and then it closes back, obviously that's all right. You don't need to do the door glitch a second time because from back here the door can always be open no matter what. And this is where, like I said, you're going to need to keep your armor going through this door the first time, and from this side it's even less consistent to actually get this clip than it is from the other side. So I'm probably just gonna cut in another one. I guess I'll explain my setup before I cut it in though. For this one, I usually just walk into the door, and like I try to get a good door hump going on. I'm not really getting one right now. I want to be walking up the door, right? But once I am doing that, I just like to look up and then, while I'm walking forward, drop my armor and hope that it pushes me through. It's just as bad as the other one, if not more so. Well, that's another thing I guess I can show off though. If you do get stuck into a door, like this is the worst thing that can happen right here. If you get stuck in a door, like you get pushed into it but you don't go all the way through, the door will eject you back out with such force you'll die. It's basically like hitting the ground at really high speed in this game. Sometimes you won't die. Like you can go from only two health of like two bars of damage taken or straight dead from full health like I just did. But I'll just cut in me actually getting the glitch now. Okay, so that's basically door glitch from the other side. And once you've gotten those three glitches, you're basically past the really luck intensive section of the game. If you actually want to get into real runs, though, you kind of need stalkers to spawn somewhere along here. Stalkers can spawn back at the Iron Forest. They can spawn up at this gas station here. They can spawn. They can spawn down the road there. They can spawn down near. There's a truck down here. They can spawn down there. And they can spawn anywhere between here, like in this dry. Lake. You can spawn anywhere between like here and the Skidovsk. But why you want the stalkers to spawn is because they can actually travel you to the Skidovsk instead of you having to run this on your own. But I will run it since I'm just gonna kind of show you guys the route while I do it, I guess. Maybe some more people will feel like running this RTA. I wouldn't really recommend going for real runs of this game, just kind of like going for fun runs, really. Real runs get kind of annoying whenever you're just resetting for the first door glitch. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go in here and talk to Owl.
What are you?
And then you can sell your armor if you want to. I'll be showing you guys two glitches, and I'll basically you get to choose which one you want to do in your runs, obviously, because they're your runs. One of them requires the armor, one of them doesn't. The one that requires the armor is a lot more luck based, though. But I'm not going to sell my armor because I have to show them both off. Selling your
That's
armor is
right.
quicker for getting to
Hey, stalker. How
Yanatzo.
are you?
But then we're going to come over here, this pilot, of course, and we're going to go to Yanov. And I think I'll just cut out this whole entire section because I don't think you guys really want to watch this long cutscene here. So the first glitch here, this one doesn't require your armor.
I'm listening, man.
And this one is a
Hey,
lot
man.
more
What's
consistent
up?
with my setup than the armor one is, because I just, at least as of right now, there's no consistent setup for that armor trick. What you're going to want to do is go into the Freedom Leader's room and just grab this little stool. And then you're going to want to push it to where I do. Maybe I'll keep all of this in for any of you that want to see me pushing it. But I'll probably just put like an annotation so you can skip to the part where I've already got it all pushed. Maybe. If I remember. I probably won't remember.
What do I do? If I go, I'll lose money. If I don't go, I'll end up dead.
And that was Vanno, of course. You don't actually need to talk to Vanno in this speedrun. You don't need to talk to Zulu either. Or Hawaiian, or any of the scientists. Yeah. This glitch is basically, if you want some spoilers, we're basically going to be skipping half of the game using this. And we're going to be going to the Pripyat tunnels. What's basically going to happen is, in this game, there's three main areas, and there's two people that can take you between those three main areas. There's Satan, Jupiter, and Pripyat, right? Satan was the first one. This is the area around Jupiter. And Pripyat is the third one that we're going to right now. And there's Gary and Pilot. Pilot's the guy we talked to take us between Zaton and Yanov, which means Gary is the guy that would take us between Yanov and Pripyat. And they can also take you to Zaton Like, Gary can take you to Zaton from Pripyat, and Pilot can take you to Pripyat from Zaton after you talk to both of them and do a bunch of stuff. But for their fast travels, I guess just because of the way that the game is programmed, they need to have two actual references in the game where if you step on that spot, you will get teleported to the other area. And I guess that they just need to be on flat ground for some reason. So I think the developers just thought, where better to put them than on a spot where nobody will be able to reach them. And so they put them up on there, and I'll explain it more once we get there. The basic setup for this trick, though, with the stool, is that you push it out here, and then there's these two really green plants, and then there's these patches of dead grass. And you can line the stool up in this patch or this patch. It doesn't really matter which one you choose. They'll both work. But what you want to do is you want to crouch down. And I like to save and then load. I find that whenever you load the game, it helps the physics bug out a little bit more. So we're going to do our load, and then we're going to crouch, and then just repeatedly like tap forward, and you can already see what's going to happen here. We just need the stool to actually be good, and anywhere around here can work. Like, anywhere in that area can work. That's a really good area for doing the trick. Sometimes it takes a few tries, though. But I shouldn't have to just cut to me actually getting it this time, since this one is fairly consistent. Like, the stool is really volatile right now. It's just not putting me up high enough. What we're doing is kind of knocking the stool into the ground while getting on top of it, so that it's pushing us back up as it gets launched out of the ground, right? It's just not putting us up high enough. Wow. I've never seen a stool that reacts this well, honestly. There we go. Okay. So, right here would be the warp. Like, I'm kind of outlining it with my crosshair. That's the warp to go to Zaton, but we don't want to go to Zaton, obviously. We want to go to Pripyat, so right along here is the way to get to Pripyat. Just make sure in your runs that you don't walk into Zaton. That's kind of the bad thing to do. But of course, before we go to Pripyat, we need to show off the secondary way, which is the harder way, but also the faster way, if done quickly. I wouldn't really recommend this one as much if you're just trying to, if you're just running the game for fun, because this is a really, really tough strat. Like, this is just as tough as the first door clips. The chair one is rather easy. What we're going to want to do here is drop our armor so that, and this is why it's tough, we need it to land with the like the boots right here. We need those to land on the ground, like horizontally along the ground, with it leaning up against the tire. We can try dropping it on the tire and then just pushing it to where it needs to go. Sometimes that works, sometimes it doesn't. Also, I'm spotted by an enemy, which could be a bloodsucker, so we might have to deal with that in a second. Sometimes he'll come up here and hit you, sometimes he won't. This can also work, by the way, but not always. So I'm just going to cut in me getting it once, I guess. This is a really tough one. So this is basically the setup that you want to get for it. This won't work every time,
But this is pretty much how you want the armor to be if you're going to be doing this. And you kind of want to get, like, because these tricks, this and the chair trick, they work by pushing the item into the ground and then being on top of it as it gets ejected back out. So this is the part that you want to use to push into the ground whenever you do this trick. I figured I'd just stop and point that out before I continue on. Well, that's all I got. That's the best I can do on this trick. So let's continue on with the rest of the run from Pripyat. From here on out, there's not really any major tricks left in the run. Like, there's no major sequence breaks. There are still tricks, but just nothing where we're going to be skipping a lot of the game. And just as reference, you can tell Kowalski about the Gauss rifle right now, but there's really no point in doing so because you don't actually have it yet, so like you still have to go get it. Now, for here, there's a small trick we're going to be doing where basically, there's a monolith sniper. Wow. Sorry. A monolith sniper, right up here with like a Gauss rifle, right? And him spawning has like a script where he's supposed to spawn and shoot that sniper that I killed as soon as he spawns. And if that sniper dies, like he doesn't spawn until a certain point otherwise. And if that sniper dies, he just spawns immediately. So killing that sniper has two benefits because one, it spawns him immediately, and two, you get his sniper rifle to kill him with. Generally, you hope to kill the sniper before he switches weapons, so you don't actually have to wait and go into his inventory. But now we can tell Kowalski all about the Gauss rifle. See, so there we go. We can go right into the having information. Didn't have to talk to
I've
Cardan.
received a message from the
Normally,
recon
at this
unit.
point, you would have to go back to Zaton. But because we did both of those skips, we don't have to. And I'm referring to the skips right at the beginning, like the two door skips.
Recon unit, come in. What is going on out there? We need to find the recon unit. Major, find out what happened. What the hell? You be careful out there, okay? And Major,
Now,
keep
the
me
next trick we're
posted.
going to get into is cutscene skipping. You can skip certain cutscenes in this game, but it's kind of hard to do. They all have different timings as well. The one that we're going to do right now, we're going to want to throw the grenade and then interact with the guy, right? You'll see the timing as I do it, but if you do it too early or too late here, you're not going to get the cutscene skip. Basically, if you take damage during a cutscene, you get to skip that cutscene. It just immediately cancels the cutscene. And for this one, and the one at, like, near the end, before you steal the explosives for the kindergarten, skipping the cutscene will lock you into a black screen where, like, you can still run around, but you're just stuck in a black screen for a while. As far as I know, those are the only two cutscenes where that actually happens. Also, my aim is really bad. Let's play Stalker Call for Cat. Bad aim edition. Alright. And for the run, you just want to come up here and. Whoops. Come up here and grab this stash. And then you're just going to switch to this gun. And I'm going to heal up for safety. Now, in here, we're going to do another cutscene skip. But you're going to see what I mean, where the black screen isn't a part of every cutscene skip. Of course, whenever you get the black screen, all you have to do is save and load like I did, but here we go. For this one, I didn't have to save and load. And this is another trick that isn't too hard, but I screw it up a lot. Basically, you just want to stand at like the top of this stair and then jump so that you land on that piece of, like the horizontal piece of steel right there. And you can just keep on going out. Yeah, I screwed this up a lot. It is a fair jump, but you know, it's not too tough. And you can skip this cutscene that we're going to see in a second. But to do it, you need to use grenades to kill the controller. I don't use grenades to kill the controller because it's really hard to get them perfectly RTA. So I just use this and get a bunch of headshots. And these pseudo dogs, they can skip you through the cutscene anyways. All they have to do is hit you during the cutscene and there you go. Get rid of it. Cool. Actually, that's pretty good luck that we got hit by those pseudo dogs. Right up here, there is on the top floor, there's a certain, like, there's a cage, like a just a fence really in one of the halls, and you're not supposed to be able to go through there. You're supposed to go all the way through this facility instead, but you can actually like it doesn't open, but you can actually skip by it by just doing this little trick here, which is, it's not a tough trick. But you will slide off the windowsill sometimes. It'll just happen. Or like, just like I just did, of course. You'll just kind of slide off. There we go. Second try isn't too bad at all. Actually, it usually takes me a couple more than that because I'm really bad at video games. And up here, I would recommend, if you're running RTA, saving before you do this jump. Because this jump can kill you, or just like that, it can take away barely any health. Fall damage is very variable. Now, there isn't really any skips here, but there is one important thing to remember to do while you're in here. You really need to remember to grab the antibiotics right here. That's the major thing. And then you just continue on as normal. The antibiotics are useful just for the the final emission that's part of the storyline. You can skip it using them. I mean, sometimes these snorks will block you. It's up to them what they want to do, really. And they're smacking me around a little bit. They don't do much damage, though, because we're on rookie, of course. The relaxed session of Stalker on rookie. Now we just want to head back to Kowalski. And I'd recommend making sure that your gun is loaded for this, like, for the next section. By the time you get to the kindergarten, have your gun loaded. That's just like a small speedrun thing. You don't really want to get to the point where you need your gun and then reload it just standing there. Should also check. Okay, I have two grenades. I believe I only have two more cutscenes that are skippable from here on out, so that should be enough. Come up here, he tells us about all the guys dying.
Agent, we've got a serious problem. This operation has been getting more ridiculous every minute since the helicopters crashed.
And yeah, once you get into Pripyat, like I said, there aren't really any large skips. There's just a lot of small time savers. Unlike in Zatan and Yana. In Zatan, the skips we did save about 5 minutes, usually, RTA. And in Yanov, we skipped the entire Pripyat tunnel, so that's like 15 minutes saved, easily. Possibly even more in RTA, depending on how quickly you can usually do grabbing the documents in the tunnel. And you skip the intro cutscene to Pripyat as well.
Given the situation we find ourselves in, this should be your priority from now on. Also, as a personal favor
some
to me,
God-tier voice acting.
Please find my boys.
And this is the section where I would recommend making sure your gun, like the magazine, is fully loaded. And this will be the second cutscene where we will need to use a quick save to continue on. Like, it'll lock us into a black screen until we save and load again after skipping this one. The timing for this one is that you want to grab the item. Like, from this guy, you want to grab the item and then you want to throw it. And make sure that you see that game saved user quick save come up before you load. You don't want to lose a run to loading the wrong quick save. I've done that before. Alright. So now there's only one more skippable cutscene in the rest of the game, I believe. And if you do want to do something where, like, you're actually going to the Stingray, like the different Stingray helicopters, you can skip the cutscenes where you examine those helicopters as well. But I figured I don't really need to show them since they aren't really part of the 80% route anymore. A little while ago they were, but ever since Onan and Ravix made the new route, you haven't needed them. So here we go. As far as anyone knows, there's no way to skip
Is that
these
really you?
cutscenes.
Well, I'll be. We were starting to think we'd never see our doc again. So what happened?
Well, it's a long story. I'll tell you another time.
Okay. Thanks for your help. By the way, the Colonel wants you to pay him a visit.
Thanks. I'll do that.
Also, Gary headed for Yanov's station to restock. He asked me to tell you that he won't be back for a few days.
Gotcha.
I spoke to the HQ commander and reported the situation to him, along with all the information that's been collected. There won't be any helicopter
I know
support
these
for a
cutscenes are
while.
really long.
He suggested that we fortify our position
Hopefully,
and
I'll
await
remember to throw
further
in like some
orders.
annotations to skip all
U.S.S.
this kind of stuff
observers are
for you guys that
currently
don't
in
want to see it.
HQ, so you'll
Or
be able
maybe
to
I'll just
talk to your
put
superiors
links in the
soon.
description to all of the
Colonel, a radio
specific
signal has been
trick
detected, and its source is not far from the
explanations.
base. The transmission is encrypted, and I haven't been able to crack it yet. Do you have the coordinates?
Yes, I have the coordinates. But the signal is intermittent, and it's moving.
Monolith again?
I'll check.
Alright. Now we have to go check it out. So in this section, there's one small thing you want to remember, and that's to switch out one of your hotkeys with the antibiotics. It's just a small time saver. It'll save you 1 or 2 seconds later on. It's not required or anything, but it is a little time saver. Having the antibiotics isn't required
The signal
either.
is back.
They're just a
Transmitting
big
coordinates.
time saver because you don't have to sit through the entire mission. This section's kind of dependent on how fast Strelok wants to move. But this is a fairly tough cutscene skip. I'll try and get though. You want to throw your grenade over to that grate just
Your signal
as
is gone.
this starts.
Major Kowalski is
There we
back.
go,
It's
just
ready to
like
attack you. We need to
that.
meet it for possible
It's moving
attack.
toward our base. Busters
Once you
won't
get
get
it, you should
shots
be able
with
to
our
get it
pants
every
down
time.
this time.
Like once you learn the positioning and timing of it, you should be able to get it every single time.
You're the stalker who disabled the Scorcher?
Yes, but my plan didn't work. I came here to speak with your commanders. I have information that will allow the army to take control of the zone and destroy it.
An emission is starting.
Come, let's talk inside.
And this is the emission that we'll be skipping via the antibiotics.
We've got a problem. Our choppers are crashing for reasons that we've not understood yet.
Until we work it out, there won't be any helicopter support. The only way to get to the borders of the zone is on foot.
The reasons are obvious. There are many anomalies in the air, especially in the center of the zone.
We had a map with the safe air corridor between anomalies, and the helicopters had emission protection systems.
That's odd. You're telling me you haven't noticed that anomalies move around after an emission. Some disappear, and new ones show up in different places, which makes your map of anomalies effectively useless.
So that's what it is.
What?
Emissions don't just follow one another. If you can scan the area and identify all the anomalies, the choppers will be able to collect us safely, provided they're dispatched right after an emission.
We must inform the HQ of this as soon as possible.
I'll contact my commanders right after the emission.
Alright, that was us taking our antibiotics. And that's why the hotkey's a little bit nicer, because you don't have to open up your inventory, you can just take them right there. And just for safety, if you want, you can always ask for the medical supplies there. Because we will need to be running through some guys.
It's impossible to establish comms during one.
Major Degtyarev here.
The end of Pripyat. It's just a lot of cutscenes in the speedrun.
I've managed to acquire documents about experiments carried out in the zone.
And there's really only one trick
we've
left
been contacted
after this.
By a stalker who's been in the CNPP. His name is Strelok, and he's offered us his cooperation. Strelok believes that the helicopters ran into anomalies. The location of anomalies changes after every emission, a fact that was missed when making the map for Operation Fairway.
The news, fellas. When we go, stick together and keep the stalker alive. Any questions? Get ready to move. Major, can I have a word?
Alright. Now, here's our last trick. Whenever some of the army die, they immediately take off with the helicopters. So we're going to be exploiting that, basically. Wow. This guy kind of pushed me away. So we'll just kill him instead. It doesn't really matter how quickly I do this, because I can still show off the trick anyways. So yeah, because we killed them, in just a few seconds, there you go. It plays that audio and then it starts the timer. Regularly, that timer wouldn't, like, that timer doesn't start until one of them dies, and regularly they wouldn't die until one of, like, the zombies killed them, right? So it can take a while for that timer to start if you're not manually killing them yourself, and normally you would kill Sokolov very quickly, unlike what I did. Fun fact in this part is that, you can really only see it during the day, but if you get here quick enough, you can see that the helicopters don't actually land. They just fly through the ground, and there are just those two static choppers. And if you come over to these helicopters, you're actually, like, too far out of this zone to finish the mission properly. But there we go. And that's it. Mission complete. That's Stalker Call Pripyat, speedrun let's play of it. So, I hope that if there were any of you out there that wanted to run it, I gave you enough tips to actually learn how to do it. I'm pretty sure I explained every trick in full. And I'll just let the credits play, I guess, to finish up this let's play. And maybe some more of you will pick this up. Or, if even if you don't, at least you might have had some fun watching this.
promotion to colonel and the position of mission coordinator. He declined the opportunity to work at the HQ and submitted a personal request to be sent to the zone as the USS permanent observer. The information about the development of psi devices obtained by Dektayev alerted USS commanders. All the information gathered on X-designated laboratories was removed from military archives and filed as top secret. All personnel working in the zone were ordered to prevent the disclosure of information about the laboratories at any cost. Several experimental samples were made on the basis of technical documents for Item 62. Following a set of test trials, it was decided not to go ahead with large-scale deployment of the weapon due to the high cost of ammunition. Nonetheless, it would be reasonable to assume that further development of the Gauss rifle is ongoing. Skadovsk became home to any and all who could reach it. Fierce stalker resistance did not stop the bandits from making regular and ultimately unsuccessful attempts to establish their so-called order on the ship. Despite this ongoing struggle, the Skadovsk carried on its unique brand of life. Unfortunately, it didn't last long. Bloodsuckers from the lair near the Skadovsk found the way to the ship. When bloodsucker attacks began to occur, even in broad daylight, it was decided to mount an assault on the lair. Unfortunately, the hunters failed to advance deep into the tunnels, and soon afterwards, a wave of bloodsuckers annihilated all the ship's residents in one fell swoop. A fragile balance was reached between Freedom and duty squads at Yanov Station. Tired of the endless struggle, fighters of both factions started leaving their squads and joining the Free Stalkers. Professors Hermann and Ozersky were forced to cut short their scientific research in the zone due to a lack of data. On returning to the outside world, the two scientists proceeded to engage in unrelated work. Gary's stories about the Army's struggle against the dangers of Pripyat encouraged stalkers to explore the ghost town. Despite the constant monolith attacks, stalkers managed to secure the former Army camp, which they used as a base to launch raids deep into the city, making slow but steady progress. The area around Yanov Station gained a reputation for being one of the most dangerous places in the zone. Fewer and fewer stalkers make it back from raids, many dying at the hands of mutants within view of the camp. One of those missing is Trapper, who set out to track down a chimera on what appears to have been his last hunt. Rumors of Zulu's fate reached the leader of duty, General Voronin. Counter to most expectations, Voronin decided to posthumously award Zulu with the Silver Shield, duty's highest decoration. Having overcome his alcoholism, Cardin left the Skadovsk. Stalkers said he went to look for his missing friends. Several days later, he returned, suffering from wounds and radiation poisoning. As soon as his wounds healed, he left the zone for the second and final time. Strelok's knowledge was lost with him. The information he found at the Chernobyl NPP, which could have been used to gain a better understanding of the zone, remained forever within its borders. It seems the zone knows how to keep its secret. Colonel Kowalski, commander of the Stingray Group, found his resting place not far from the majority of his squad. Their bodies were taken in by the zone, with nothing but old faded photographs left to remain.